Sugar is something that we all need as a vital part of our diet. We get most of it from carbohydrates in our food, things like potatoes, bread and rice, as well as sugars in fruit and honey. But we can also get it straight, as a pure product manufactured from crops like sugarcane, grown mainly in the tropical parts of the world, or sugar beet, more popular in temperate areas such as the United States and Europe. Sugar beet has been an important crop for farmers in the English Midlands and Eastern Counties for nearly a century. From the building of the first processing factory at Cantley in Norfolk in 1912, right up to the present day, beet has been grown here and turned into sugar, molasses, animal feed and other products. The process involves a lot of washing to remove dirt, stones and weeds. It's then sliced and cooked to extract the sugar, while leaving the dry matter as sugar beet pulp for animal feed. The sugar solution is then filtered, purified and boiled down to concentrate it into a thick juice, from which the sugar itself is crystallised. The residual syrup is sold as molasses. The result is one of the purest forms of food known to man, although many others are of course needed to make up a complete diet. The factory is of course the final stage in a year-long process, during which the crop is sown, grown and harvested. Processes which have changed a great deal over the years. It was once a very labour-intensive process, with the seeds drilled in rows, which then had to be gapped and singled to leave individual plants at a spacing sufficient to make sure they got enough light to grow well. That job was abolished with the invention of the monogerm seed. That consisted of a single seed in a clay coating, which could be drilled at the right spacing straight away. It allowed the establishment of the crop to be carried out by one man on a tractor. Weed and pest control have been similarly reduced by the application of crop protection products. But the biggest change has probably been in the harvesting of the beet. An event held on Mr. and Mrs. Robinson's farm at Glinton near Peterborough in the autumn of 2005 set out to show just how much change there had been. On one single field, volunteers harvested beet using everything from knock and chop with their bare hands to massive machines that can clear acres.